Hi guys, I'm so excited to be here on mKidz Online. I think it's amazing that the churches of the New Testament, that's the second part of the Bible, has so much to teach us. In the next couple of weeks, we are going to journey with them. Are you ready? Well, I definitely am. So let's get going. My name changed. I went blind for a while. I wasn't one of the 12 disciples. I wrote many of the letters to the early congregations. Can you guess who I am? Paul.
Have you ever wondered how the church started? How did congregations begin? Of course, there have been groups of people who follow God and come together to worship and serve Him since way back when. But how did the first Christian churches begin? By that I mean, how did people who follow Jesus, who was resurrected, start to be the church of Christ? Well, Jesus called some leaders and people started talking and spreading the good news, the gospel. At first, people just gathered in houses and encouraged each other to keep following Jesus. Later, the groups of people grew. We read about these congregations in the New Testament. We can learn quite a lot from the first congregations in the Bible. They did not always have all the answers or know exactly what to do to follow God. They did not even always get along with each other, but they could always turn to Jesus and ask the Holy Spirit to fill them and guide them again and again to show His love for the world. So for a few weeks, we are going to explore what advice and lessons we can get and that we can learn from the lives of these congregations. We are going to do this by looking at certain Bible books in the New Testament. We call them the letters in the Bible written to specific congregations. Today, we start with Romans. Romans.
Let's read from Romans 12. Therefore, I urge you, brothers and sisters, in view of God's mercy, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God. This is your true and proper worship. Do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is, His good, pleasing, and perfect will. This is a piece of the letter written to the congregation of Romans.
Imagine our church received a letter from someone with incredible faith, doing amazing things with God everywhere he goes. I would like to hear what he has to say, wouldn't you? Now, imagine the whole congregation coming together here in the church building, ready to hear one of our leaders read the letter aloud. We are all ready to get advice on how we can live more like God wants us to live, and the letter being read gives us advice on how to do this. Amazing, right? Today, we really did listen to a part of a letter written to a congregation, Romans 12. Perhaps remember these three important pieces of advice today. Give your whole life to God as a sacrifice, a gift. Your life is safe in His hands, and He knows what is good and necessary. You can stand before God with open hands and surrender everything you have and are. It is quite liberating to learn to trust God in this way. Then, do not become like the wrong or bad things of the world. We live in the world, but we should not just go along when things are wrong. We are Christians, and we must live like Christians. We sometimes have to stand up against what is wrong and stand strong in who we are in Jesus. We are in the world, but also different. Not because we are better than others, but because we are new people since Jesus saved us and teaches us every day to be more like Him. Lastly, let God shape your thoughts, what you think, and make them what He knows is good. Our mind is almost like a control room of our whole being. Let God enter your mind and let Him help you think as He teaches and guides you to think. He will help you to let go of negative and bad thoughts and rather fill your head with positive and good thoughts. You don't have to feel guilty if you sometimes think a bad thought. Just pray immediately, "Jesus, renew my mind. I want to think as you teach me and lead me to think." Let's read these pieces of advice together again. Give your whole life to God as a sacrifice. You are in the world, but also different from the world. Let God shape your thoughts. I think if we take this good advice to heart and we do what Paul is inviting us to hear, it will change our lives and help us feel close to God. I think we will also be able to act with more love towards other people. Will you take this advice and keep it in your heart? You can also talk to someone in your household about it as you explore what this can mean in your life.
Through you the blind will see, through you the mute will sing, through you the dead will rise, through you all hearts will praise, through you the darkness flees, through you my heart screams, I am free. And I am free to run, and I am free to run, I am free to dance. Sing. Through you the dead will rise, through you all hearts will praise, through you the darkness flees, through you my heart screams, I am free.
Let's pray together. Lord, thank you so much for this life that you've given us. Teach us how to give our lives as an offer to you and to stand up against what is wrong with wisdom. Thank you, Lord, that you teach us every day, that you lead us. Help us to follow you in everything that we do. Amen. Bye, guys.